This is Merryn Jose, and you're listening to MerlianPodcast.com. Today we have with us Helen Celestine Escoffier. Helen is a Reiki Master teacher, Interfaith Minister, imagery guide, and spiritual coach. She is the founder of Star Visions, a center for the healing arts and spiritual enrichment. Additionally, she stays grounded as an associate broker with Sotheby's International Realty. Welcome to Merlian Podcast, Helen.
Thanks, Merryn. It's great to be here.
So a warm welcome to Merlian Podcast, Helen. It's so nice to have you here today.
Thank you, Merryn. It's great to be here.
Well, what is so interesting is we've known each other over, 12 years or so?
I think so, 12, 13.
And I know you started Star Visions 17 years ago, something like that?
Yes, officially about 17 years ago, 1990.
So I'm really interested. In fact, I've never asked you this. How did you actually get started with Star Visions?
Well, it is my story. I was in real estate, still am, and I started my own company with my mother back in the late 80s. And anybody in the real estate world will know that the late 80s was a very soft market, and I had a lot of time on my hands. And it was a time that I started to go deeper into what my interest has been all my life, and that's the study of the healing arts and spiritual development, something that I always have been involved in.
And were you interested in this as a child?
Always, yes, absolutely. It was an interest, but certainly not something that I ever thought could make a profession out of.
So when did you decide it, you could make a profession
well,
out of it?
Well, that was what was interesting. When I had the downtime in the late 80s to enter a new community of people who were all associated with the healing arts, I started to meet people that were making professions out of their healing work. They were practitioners. And I started to look at myself a bit differently, and saw that maybe I could make my own work out there in a more professional way. And I started to apply certain other skills from my background, for instance, networking, which we can talk about more.
Oh, yes, that's very important.
Yeah, it really is. And I started to apply the concepts of building a career that I had used in real estate, applying it to building a career in the healing arts.
That's amazing. And the other thing, you I know are a Reiki master and an interfaith minister. So you did a lot of study yourself. So it's
Absolutely.
Not that you just organize things. You actually are a practitioner yourself.
That's where it all started, and that's really the heart of who I am. I was out there pursuing my own teachings and spending a lot of time with magnificent teachers, really very enthusiastic about what I was learning and wanting to share what I was learning with others and share the teachers.
Can you tell
us
a little bit about your teachers and how that, in fact, inspired you to bring them to Star Visions, I think?
Well, that
and
is
present
what
them then.
I had wonderful teachers. Some of them were the Reiki masters that I studied with, and others were, let's say, practitioners in other healing arts, other crafts, sound workers like John Beaulieu, just a wonderful, wonderful teacher, and composer. And I, for instance, John might be a good example. He was one of my early presenters at Star Visions.
I remember I went to one of the workshops.
Oh.
He was wonderful.
He really was. I had taken a few programs with him in the city, in New York City, and I would be talking about him to the people in the Westchester, New York area where I live, and they were very excited about studying with him, but they wouldn't leave Westchester to go to the city.
So you brought?
So I brought John here.
Wonderful.
And that's where it started. I started to see that there was an audience to be developed for these wonderful people, wonderful teachers, and I started to ask my teachers to come to me, and I would have the audience for them.
And since then,
it's grown and blossomed, mm-hmm. and I have people from around the world.
Yes.
From around the States, Canada,
and England.
Yes. Absolutely. You've been very important to getting the people from England.
Yes,
here.
You've just had David Cunningham here, who's an incredible healer.
Magnificent.
Yes, wonderful. And I believe you also have had Heather Cumming.
Yes.
She's worked, and she is the translator and writer for the Book of John of God.
Exactly. And she will continue to do more work at Star Visions, more teachings.
She's a shaman, isn't she?
Yes, yeah. Yes, and wonderful.
She's a very amazing woman.
That's, and I've had Louis Melmadrona,
who
you have interviewed previously.
Yes.
A wonderful Native American healer and doctor, physician. And then there's Robert Moss.
Oh, he's brilliant.
Absolutely.
The dream man.
Yes.
The dream maker. He's so incredible, Robert. And, of course, Roland Comtois.
Yes, Roland. Such a love, such an angel.
And such a great medium.
And you know what all of these people share in common is the intention to be of service and to heal.
Yes. Very much so. Tell us a little bit then, Helen, about the importance of networking.
I believe, at least for my purpose, networking is essential. And it's about getting out there, interacting with others, expressing shared interests, learning about other people, making connection. And Star Visions is about offering a space where people can further connect and network, interact, learn, grow, heal. And for the presenters too, it offers them an opportunity to grow in their own work and draw in more people who needs to learn from them.
Of course. And also, you do weekend workshops, don't you?
I do weekend, weekday.
Yes.
It's almost 24/7. Presenters come and stay at my facility.
Yes.
It's a very unique property, home.
Oh, it's very special.
It is very special. Mm.
So, Helen, I'd like to go back a little bit. Your mother was a reader of the Destiny cards, I believe.
Yes, she was.
And she was a tremendous character.
Oh, absolutely.
So you obviously had great support from your mother.
Yes, I did. And I had it from my father and brother as well. My whole family really supported all of my intention along the way. I think that's a very important piece that I want to honor. I had the support of my family. Very independent people, and yet we allowed each other to develop their interests with just that support. And Mom was very much involved in this work. She remains the heart of Star
yes.
Visions.
I always remember her sitting there holding court.
Oh, absolutely. The Grand Dame.
Yes.
The High Priestess.
That's right.
But it's very important to recognize that my family did give me the support, and that foundation really allowed me to fly with my dreams.
So, Helen, what is your vision for Star Visions? How do you see it expanding in the future?
I see the vision being one of global connection. What unifies so many of us at Star Visions, the presenters, myself, the audience, is we're recognizing this is a time of great shifting in consciousness. And I want to be part of that shift of consciousness to raise our vibration, to unify us all. And that has to be on a global level.
Yes.
And I have you to thank a lot for the people that come, the teachers, because a lot of them come because of you, Merryn, and the wonderful networking that you're doing. Mm-hmm. And all of them share this global vision as well.
Yes. Well, you and I work very well as a
team.
Yes,
we do.
I mean, we're sending back, forth, back, forth. So it's fun, and we see the expansion on
Absolutely.
Both levels. It's really quite tremendous. So, Helen, what changes have you seen in what people are actually looking for in the presenters? There must be, it must have changed its format in a way.
Yeah, there are shifts of direction, maybe. In the beginning, it was about having presenters in to do their teachings and leave.
Mm.
And now it has evolved to the same teachers are coming in, doing an introduction to their work and to their teachings via, let's say, a workshop presentation.
Mm.
But what people are looking for now is more of an individualized connection, a lot of private sessions now.
Yeah.
The same presenters that I had years ago doing just their presentation are now being asked to stay and do private sessions.
Actually, I noticed that with Jude Caravan, the physicist.
Yes.
She came and gave a workshop, and then you told me that she was completely fully booked on one-to-one sessions
Absolutely.
Afterwards.
And now
yes.
I am getting a big draw for people to have Jude come back to teach her healing ways.
Oh, wonderful. That's so interesting.
And Lewis, the same thing.
Yes.
Lewis was here just, you know, doing workshops and presentations, but now people are asking for private sessions. And David Cunningham, who was just here from
yes.
England, he came here in this area. He was not known.
Mm-hmm.
Within 2 weeks, he handled 93 sessions.
My goodness.
People are so thirsty
yes.
for this.
Yes. That's wonderful change. Helen, for my last question, where do you see star vision's place in the world in the next decade, next 10 years?
Boy, Merryn, that's a loaded question. I don't know where star vision's is going to be in the next 10 minutes.
good answer.
This whole journey has been about listening to my inner guidance system.
Mm.
And when I have, I've been steered in only magnificent directions. Mm. And it really is based on inspiration and the ever-changing world that we live in. And I just hope to remain open to what I'm guided to do.
Yes.
Inspired to do, who I'm inspired to have at Star Visions, and just allow the process to be the adventure and the fun that it is.
Oh, Helen. Well, you're inspiring for all of us, believe me. Thank you so much today, and I hope that you'll... before we go, sorry, folks, can you give us your new website?
Oh, sure.
Okay.
I'm so excited about my new website.
Oh, it's wonderful.
It's www.starvisions.org.
So, Helen, it's been a great pleasure, as I've said.
Thank you, Merryn. It's been great fun.
Oh, yes, it has, and we'll have more fun in the future.
Absolutely.
This is Merryn Jose, and thank you for listening to Merlian Podcast.